Hey, thank you for joining us on PlanetSide 2's work in progress for Hossin. Today we're going to be taking a look at some of the bases on Hossin that we haven't quite gotten to on the initial release for it. In particular, right now I'm going to be looking at Small Outpost 7, which is our one of the Small Outposts in the Northern Rim. And let me see, get you into the game camera here. So we're going to be taking a look at the space that I'm working on here. It was originally the Supply Depot, Small Outpost 7, up on the north end of the continent. Busy loading chunks, and inverted is still on. Actually, give me one moment. Joining us on PlanetSide 2's work in progress for Hossin. Today's for it. In particular, right now, I'm going to be looking at Small Outpost 7. Sorry, I've had sound cutting into this thing. Is the sound good right now? Yeah, let me see if I can cut the music out for that until we figure out how to get that fixed. So I believe that should be fixed then. All right, so we're going to take a look at this base right now. There we go. This is what we have so far. I've been working on it for about a day now to get some of the basics in, so we don't have to start at a base that's just been done from scratch. So what we've got here so far is a pretty basic flow with the spawn room over here, in the big picture view. We've got the main road coming in this way, and also through this way, with a cap point intended to be in the center part of this this tree log over here. We're going to have the teleporter room over here, and I think today we're going to focus on kind of polishing this up, getting some of this finalized, and hopefully seeing this in game pretty soon. So let's start getting the work on that. So what I want to do first here is finish up where the teleporter room and the spawn room are going to be before we start filling in the rest of it. Those are kind of important to make sure that we have the proper flow for everything here. So what I'm going to do over here is... we need a terminal over here. Prudentia, this base was the supply depot, which has a ton of jump pads that take you across the streets. You can't really see anything of it now. I've kind of erased what was here before and replaced it with this current setup right here. I've got concrete platforms with kind of like a slight grade to them to make them look a little bit more interesting. And I've got two Xander garages at either end. They're going to be your expected places to park this if you're looking for the easiest spot. Cap point I'm going to put probably behind over here in this area, away from the main spawn room. And the teleporter room back here is not going to have direct line of sight on this this back area over here. Wabberjockey asked, has anything in the data from live started to have impact on these base designs yet? Yeah, some of the stuff that we've been doing in, lately with them has, or some of the stuff from what I've seen, at least on live, of how some of them has flowed has started to make some, you know, ideas of what we want to do with some of these bases. This one in particular, I had looked at it. Let me change some of my preferences here. I had looked at it earlier and knew that I don't think it was going to really work with what we wanted out of. That is backwards for me. What we wanted with this particular base, just because it wasn't really. It was kind of following old design as opposed to what we found out what works now. So that's why I'm going to make this more of a linear tug-of-war sort of fight between attackers coming from here to there, there to there, and the defenders attacking or trying to take the point back going that way, defenders also coming there from the teleporter room. Let me see if I can get another Twitch window open here. I was getting crosstalk before, and it was confusing me. I think I just need to mute it. Give me 1 second. So let's make sure that we have this platform finished before we go any further. Okay, Rad, I got the chat over here so I can see what you guys are saying. Yeah, Prudentia, the construction site bases are kind of intended to play pretty well, even though they aren't very... They're not too unique from each other. But I think the way they turned out ended up being pretty good for what we wanted out of them, which is just a quickly stampable. It takes maybe only 8 hours to get those things put together as opposed to some of the other bases that are unique and handcrafted. Those can take a fair amount of time. Additionally, I don't have a widget, apparently. You can blame Malorn for the slowness right here. I'm trying to select objects and I don't have my setups. Translate, rotate, scale. There we go. Okay, we're back in business. We're not. I'm sorry, folks. One moment. There we go. All right. Before I go any further, I am repeatedly hitting something here. Hitting the smooth tool. Alright, so we've got this platform ready, partially to go. Start deleting these. So I am going to continue to go back to my hotkeys to find out where all of these buttons that Malorn likes to press are currently set up, because they're everywhere. They are absolutely everywhere. All right. Yeah, I should probably copy over my own editor program before I go into this disaster again. Trying to figure out exactly what these permissions are set up. Why, when I move my camera around, I keep switching to a different tool. WASD is just not for some people, apparently. Take this, and I'm going to start rotating this 45 degrees in the other angle. Also, something is mapped to Q, apparently. Yeah, it's level. There we go. I think we are finally out of hotkeys that are not the defaults. Yojimbo, we were actually looking at the Interlink facility yesterday about what we're doing with that. There's nothing exactly planned on when it's going to come out, but we are still looking, we are beginning to start tasking that out again. We haven't worked on it for a little while because we had kind of cut it for Hossin, the initial launch, and we'll be taking a look at that again soon. It's definitely far along enough that it's not something we're going to scrap. So. No plans for a dropship facility just yet. All right, so I'm going to try to make these sort of flush at least with each other. Probably cover this up with something because it doesn't look right. Kind of like how I have these here, the corners don't really show very well with the concrete. That is not set to hide. So we should be able to get this to line up a little bit, and these are set back 10 degrees too, so don't take that. It's sticking out a little bit. Barber Jockey, I'm not particularly fond of it. It's just one of those things that's not a really high priority. I personally would not like that to be a thing, but it's one of the time things. Redoing that much geo is pretty time consuming. Oh, it's not super easy to do so. It used to be way worse before, and we had fixed it so that it was at least more difficult to do, but we'll have to take a look at that again. I thought you were talking about the large towers that like at Crossroads or the Crown. Yes, I do work for SOE on PS2. Switchback, they are watching the World Cup right now. It's pretty much the same. Thank you. is that sticking through too? The base that's being worked on right now is, I actually haven't named it yet, in all honesty. I have no idea, Terminal 6, if the flag decals are going to disappear when the World Cup is over. I don't know what our plan is for keeping those things on the marketplace is. Should be almost done with our platform here. Now is that I save this particular chunk that I'm working on really quickly. 1640. All right, so hopefully that's saved. If not, I've wasted a lot of, I'll be wasting a lot of time today. That part of it. I'm going to. What I should do with the back. There's our vehicle terminal. It's hiding under here. Am I working off of sketches? Spawn room teleporter version over here. No, that's not the one. There we go. So we've got that one. Shouldn't have too much height on the other, on this platform here. This one's going to have a wall that kind of prevents you from shooting from the spawn room to this point too, so. Switchback. I had a lot of fun working on Hossin. And I'm glad the feedback on it's been pretty positive. You're worried that some of the stamp bases or some of the bases around the outer rim weren't going to go over so well, but even them, they've been pretty well received. Yeah, the trees worked out pretty well too. The dynamic around them of kind of separating air and ground forces has been more than I was expecting out of it, actually. I was expecting it just to be air cover, but it actually has, there's a game up, a game basically, it's in the the air that, you know, the ground doesn't really get to see now. So I'll make sure that this is kind of flush with this platform over here. I want to keep the same height. So Wobber Jockey has asked what my favorite bass is on Hossin to make and to play in. It's a tough one. So in terms of both that I worked on worked and have played on at the same time, the only one I've really worked on that I enjoyed playing on a ton that I was like on work in progress. I really liked how the Ziggurat turned out, although there's some issues with it that we're kind of working on. I put more cover up on the spawn platforms, but I think I might need to make the spawn and teleporter room platforms a little bit bigger just to kind of prevent vehicles from doing so much damage up there. It kind of gets swarmed a little bit easier than I was expecting originally. And so there's some stuff too, like being able to get harassers up there that wasn't exactly within our... wasn't within the scope of what I was expecting out of it, so we're gonna have to go back there and kind of clean some of that stuff up. But Ziggurat, I think, is my favorite that I've worked on, that I've played on. I haven't played on Genudyne Holographics yet, but the Ancien Connery just captured Hossin last night in an alert. So I think the warp gates have changed once that opens back up. I haven't played since last night, so. But yeah, I'll be doing some changes to the Ziggurat to make sure that it's got the best experience for it, because I definitely wasn't happy when it was just like, oh no, they've got a Sunder up here with two Bulldogs on it. Wasn't exactly what I was expecting. So be taking care of that soon. We should have a patch out with some updates to Hossin already coming out pretty soon. So in the back here, I think I'm going to raise up the terrain a little bit and then just have the concrete kind of form a back wall, because I really don't want too much gameplay out here. It's the edge of the world. There is nothing out there. There's supposed to be enemy-free zones. It's worked pretty well putting a pain field up on that big area, just to kind of discourage spawn camping and stuff like that. It was a relatively simple and easy change to make that has kind of worked out in anybody who's defending's favor, so that's kind of how we're planning on going about it from here on out. Yeah, I mean, you're going to run into the occasional edge case where if you're trying to spawn at the thing in the last second, you might eat it to the pain field, but we kind of consider that trade-off acceptable when it comes to the downsides of being spawn camped, so... That was kind of the choice we made with that. I'm happy with it. Yeah, I feel you, man. I've tried coming up with better balance to be able to pull out, like having the vehicle term. If you look at Genesis Terraforming Plant, I actually did that on that purposely to make it so that you can hack it if you want to, because you're able to get outside of the pain field. It's really close, and I mean, you're able to hack the vehicle terminal to get a vehicle, but at the same time, it's really risky to do so because it's so close to the spawn rooms. Yeah, you're going for you're going for pretty risky stuff, and a lot of times if you try to hack the vehicle terminals in some of the bases now, you'll still be able to pull vehicles out of them, but usually it's pretty dangerous to do so. And like I said, I'm actively trying at this point to try and pull some of those out of them to make it so that you can actually hack those. But the trade-off for that, I think, is greater for what we had, the choice we had to make with that of, you know, helping prevent spawn capping versus infiltrators hacking vehicle terminals. And I know it's definitely, there's definite cons to it, but it's a better change overall. But we can go forward with, you know, with these and help kind of pull the vehicle terminals out of the pain field. In this case, I don't know what I'm going to be able to do with it, though. This one's kind of... I've got the vehicle pad down here. Maybe I could sink this down. But then you'd still... So part of the problem, too, when you start thinking like that is like, well, I have it here, so maybe I could put... Yeah, I might have to think about this one. I don't want it so that you have to actually really hike very far outside of the spawn room to go get one. So it's like in this one, I don't know if it's worth putting all the extra effort into getting this vehicle terminal. Yeah, Doombro, those were, Doombro asked, you know, remember the old spawn rooms and the attackers go on the bottom floor? Those had some pros and cons to them. Like, they prevented vehicles from spamming too hard in there because they had their own inventory in there, but at the same time, it was like, yeah, you could jump down and then somebody has a anti-infantry mana turret lined up right where the drop point is, so it didn't work out the way we were hoping. Maybe I could just put the vehicle terminal here. That's not very far from getting out of there. Maybe I'll have the pain field end over in this area over here. So we're going to work on this back platform over here again. So we've got this road going out, so this one might be a little bit more of a hike to get to, which is understandable. It's the teleporter room. It's not the fastest way to get to the action over here. Keeping in mind here, though, that we have to keep pretty... Let's see what the vehicle clearance is here. We have to... Sunders are... I'm going to check how wide it is. It's definitely high enough for Sunders to get under there. But I want to see how many tanks can fit under here, because I don't want these things to be too claustrophobic. DPO, static vehicles. Yes, in a perfect world, you're looking at maybe three vanguards right now. Probably go for a little bit wider than that. So that looks better. You can probably cram four in there. Shoulder to shoulder. So we're going to copy this half step platform style over here. The other side. I think it's probably going to be up a little bit compared to the other one, maybe. No. That's right. I gotta put a wall up here too. So this side's going to be a little wider. Maybe they're actually both the same. I was expecting this one to be a little bit... Yeah, it's kind of tight over there, and the rest of it just kind of follows that. These areas are going to be a little more open just for whatever vehicle combat we have over here. It's pretty low down. It's not like you're going to be able to get too much of a good angle up there if you're trying to shoot things, maybe except on this corner over here. And I think I'm just going to put platforms over there to kind of protect the infantry that are trying to go through there. So you've got these two end buildings that are going to look down. You're going to have this one with the balcony that looks over down that way. This one with the balcony that kind of looks directly over the cap point, which is going to be over here. You pull that over, because that's sitting over here behind the teleporter somewhere. This is where we're expecting the cap point to be. So the cap point is not going to have a ton of cover on it. It's going to have some stuff I'm going to throw down over here. But you're going to have to actually really take into account what's going on in these two buildings over here. They're going to have some reason to actually kind of hold these down. Because the second that you lose this upper floor, you can't cover this spawn point anymore. Totem's asking, what base am I designing? Currently I'm doing a kind of... tree research looking garden base on Hossin. This is replacing Small Outpost 7, which is a supply depot in the northern part of the continent over here. Just for anybody who's tuning in right now. So we've got our vehicle terminal over here, our cap points over there, spawn point, and our teleporter room platform, which is being put together at this moment. Sure that this thing's up on its own little island by itself too, so gotta continue with these walls. Sir Kane, that's just the way things go sometimes. Sometimes your arm goes into a wormhole. Yeah, I was thinking about that Wobberjockey, about putting some sort of platforms up here that's... I don't want it to be too cheesy, but I might just end up, like, cramming a couple mining platforms in the side of this thing that are kind of, like, braced into it that I guess you can snipe from, but I don't want to make the cover too powerful. Like, I might end up putting a tree and a planter or something over here so that you can't just sit here and shoot people coming out of the spawn room. Because if there's a tree right here, nothing really you can do if you're up there. Grim said, we plan on fixing the drop pod bug pretty soon. We're looking into it. They were talking about it today, actually. See, that's the only real mesa that's over there. We can put a big tree over here. This is inside the chunk border. Yeah. Thank you, Sir Ken. Just checking to see how these angles look from over there. Probably gonna end up extending the pain field to just like right over here, and the rest of it is just whatever. So yeah, there's gonna be people that are shooting from there and there. So I think if I take these and just move some, I'll garden this up over here. Is I want to cap off this ugly rim thing here. So I don't know what to do with that. This is decent cover to jump around on. No. So I make this a big... That's just kind of like a natural rampart. How that's going to feel. Is the terrain sticking through those rocks? Platforms on their side over here, and that's a decent ramp up. So now you're going to be able to use these to kind of fire down on infantry, or, vehicles that are coming up down this way. stronger on one side than the other. So there goes our symmetry. This over 10 meters, whatever this is, 7 meters. Take this, copy it over, and just based around that. So I want some cover to be able to pop out and do that. I have to put another concrete block in this corner, by the way, too. Geez, I'm going to have to make it more negative 13. Yeah, that should be good. There we go, it's not sticking through anymore. Put this here when I said we were going to move it. Shameful. Nothing is symmetrical over here. Sloppy. That's what this brick is going to do. It's going to cover up our mistakes. Heck, at this point, why not just use AC units? It makes more sense. Cool, we're all right with this. Nobody's ever going to say anything about it, right? Fence posts are my Band-Aid for prop hinges and all that sorts of stuff. Put that down because I don't want people jumping up there. Oh, my props are unhidden now. So I gotta fill this pit up over here. So I just make sure that the verts don't go through the concrete blocks and we're good. I think I hid them. I think I just straight up deleted them. I don't know if my hotkey for hide is still working though. So let's see here. Show objects, Alt 1. So yeah, anything I press, Alt 1's not showing anything, so those things are deleted now. Alright, so we're going to go through here. This spawn platform is almost done. It needs to get painted, but that's we'll start polishing towards the end. I wanted to kind of show how more of the intermediate phase of designing one of these ends up going. Because the last two that I've shown, it's kind of been from scratch with the Genudyne Holographics and the Ziggurat. We're both pretty much just like, we don't got anything here, and we're going to try and get some framework of something before it's finished. You've seen how those have come out, but you don't get to see the interim. I like how there's this conversation in chat right now about, like, the secret hidden building under Rashnu. I don't know if it's true or not. I haven't looked at it. Yeah, Wobber Jockey, those things were deleted. There shouldn't be anything under there anymore. So that's... I just unhid everything, so... I gotta get railings on these stairs. This base will be OSHA compliant. Is essential, possibly, when we start deleting this. Yeah, I guess that looks stupid. We're gonna leave those rocks there then. Now we have band-aids to cover up band-aids. Victor, we have... What is this? We've got... 30 meters, 40, 50, 60. So you're maybe like 80 meters from there. I think the distances between the teleporter and the spawn room are pretty good. I'm not sure if this is glowing egg territory or not. Let me check around the surrounding stuff here. So we have specific limitations on what we're... Yep, this is blue bulb town. So for... Oh, oh man. I am lying. I guess this is the juncture point, so... I guess we can put the red eggs down. Those are going to be useful when you put them kind of across the little side area here, so if somebody's hiding behind that thermal, we'll just, like, go pass over them. Lubio, basically the way it works is that we have a few extra polys that gets used from these, but polys isn't really one of the big things that we're worried about. For performance stuff, it's typically object count and individual dip calls. So what happens here is that I've got a ton of these things already, and the renderer in the game goes, okay, there's one of these 4x4 platforms at this location, this location, this location, this location, this location, and it basically is a lot easier to process than if each one of those 4x4 platforms was 16 one-piece platforms. So that's why we do stuff like this. Now, if this was, like, a lot more complex rather than this very basic wireframe, it's not, I mean, it's relatively complex, but it's not super wild. All right. So I think this platform is at least kind of, like, penciled in what we want to do with it. Level geometry is an objects or the terrain? The terrain, I don't believe, is instanced. Victor, I'm not sure exactly what's going on with the PMC stuff. That's more of a coder thing. Because I can't fix any crashes. Unless I've made a crash, then I can probably fix it, but when it comes to the engine, it's nothing I'm particularly involved in. Alright, so we gotta shrink this thing to fit this railing. There we go. Getting wedge pieces for these so that we can make these platforms look like they're supported by something other than being of, like, made out of some magic material that doesn't obey the laws of gravity. My railings are a little off. And copy this over again. Same thing with the other side over here. There we go. Yeah, I'd be pretty bummed if I had to place each and every one of those individually. Okay, so we think the basic frame of this is at least mostly good to go now. So we can start doing some of the other stuff, like fixing these roads up, get into some of the polish phase for this. Exposing God knows what under here. There's a bunch of rocks, apparently. Smoothing out this road. are going over the vertex painting. Vertex painting is basically just a basic color that goes over the different textures painted on there to kind of give a different color. So we have like this like green, which is supposed to kind of like frame rocks, but we don't have rocks here anymore, so we don't need this. So I'm going to go over that. This will brighten it up so that it looks like a road rather than, I don't know what you would call that. Kind of looks like some sort of like mossy, dried out riverbed or something. Down here. Same thing, we've got this rock or grassy wall over here, and we want to make sure that this kind of looks and fits in with the rest of the stuff that we got over here. Maybe I can bring this down, and then this will just be like a boulder over here, and you can kind of use your infantry to kind of walk around it. That sounds better than just having this kind of like be a raised platform. We still have to worry about our hack together solution over here with the AC unit. You're removing terrain paints, you uncover a lot of stuff. Like we have a bunch of road textures over here that didn't get pulled out when we did that. So we've got this open space over here. I think it's going to be home for a small rock cluster. What else do we got? I like this one. This one looks cool. We're going to use Rock Group 05. Where did that go? So apparently a key is set to speed up the camera speed, so I got to find out where that is, because it's driving me nuts. And the camera should not be flying anywhere. And we're going to drop down Rock Group 05. I like the way that fits in there like that. So now we've got this little side lane over here for infantry, whether they're coming from the teleporter room or whether they're traversing this ditch for some reason. If there's any downside to actually just putting a stairway over here. So we're going to have a sunder bubble that's probably going to be big enough to encompass the majority of this, so you won't be putting a sunder over here, because this is a bad location to put that in anyway. But I don't think there's any reason why you wouldn't want to have a platform over here. Up the road first. Yeah, Leonard, we didn't unfortunately get as much testing as we wanted to on Hossin because we wanted to get it released in the early expedition status that it's currently in. We did a bunch of testing passes to make sure basic functionality of being able to pull like cat or being able to cap points, spawn rooms, vehicles, stuff like that, but there's some stuff that we've run into, like, that wasn't tested as, like, some of it. Like I was saying earlier, the Ziggurat has, like, a spot that you can, you know, drive sunders through and stuff like that, and that'll be fixed, really, really soon, but is kind of a dead end once you get in there. But it's good to hide from tanks if they're on the road, because they're not going to really be able to get back here and do much damage, and you can just kind of circle around this thing or jump on top and C4 them when you're down here. This is a good spot to jump down if you see a bunch of vehicles on the road. This is going to be a vehicle, or this is going to be an infantry path, Wabrachaki, rather than a vehicle path. It won't be a Sunder spot because I think the bubble is going to be big enough, too, and I don't think it's that good of a spot to put one in, especially since it's in view of the spawn room here. But maybe we can put a tree over here to kind of make it an option. I don't know. Yeah, maybe I should sink these rocks down so they don't look like a good Sunder spot. I'm going to place a Sunder dummy next to this, and it's going to vary, be obviously sticking up next to it, so hopefully it will deter people from putting a Sunder here. Those rocks are bigger than I thought. There is going to get hit pretty quick, so I'm going to sink this one down. Sink this one down a little bit. Yeah, that looks like a nice rock pile, and it is absolutely in view of this. The terrain over up around here too, so you can't. Now you're absolutely discouraged from parking over here. Especially when I do this. Check purification. It's down this road. We've got these berms over here. I want to take this and move it down a little bit. I'm going to do the same thing with this this alcove I'm carving over here. Is over here, kind of this little turnaround spot for. That's pretty cool in the office. Mevlin, we had music on before, and it was fading in and out really quickly. So, we're gonna have to. I'll have to have AV look at that after I'm done over here, before I put music back on, because it was seriously going like full blast and then dead silence and then full blast again. Crosby, Stills, and Nash. It's not Dad Rock in progress. So I've got this big sheer cliff here, and it doesn't look all that good because I just flattened it. So what I'm going to do is take the hill tool and sink this down a little bit to kind of make it look a little bit more eroded. Senior Steve, I haven't written the lore for this base yet, so you may have to stick to some of the other bases for your guild's roleplay until we kind of hammer down exactly what this base is going to be doing. Spokespy, I was actually talking earlier with some of the people on the level design team about Nexus. There's some stuff I'd like to do to it in terms of visual improvements, but I don't really want to redo too much of it. I'm pretty happy with how it turned out. I think a lot of people are happy with how it turned out in terms of like the actual base design and stuff with it. But it's got some terrain adjustments and some of the base walls and stuff like that I'd like to kind of like doll up a little bit before we put any of the Battle Islands live. But that's kind of my take on it. We don't have anything official on that just yet. That's kind of me just saying I would like to do this, but whether or not I will get the time slotted for it is up in the air. So this is an alternate Sunder spot if you don't want to have the very obvious one over here. Not that this one isn't a little obvious by itself, but we've got this one over here, and it's going to be a little bit hard for vehicles to kind of just roll out and start blowing them up. They've got to go out, and then they've got to go around here, and you're going to have enough infantry coming off of this thing to be, you know, like, okay, cool, we'll take shots at this guy when it comes out, so. Waffle Taco, we are working on a small outpost. It's the supply depot in northern Hossin that we are revamping currently. Let's get back to this road. So I'm going to lower these berms a little bit. I think these things are kind of restrictive. Got space back here. It's like over here too. This is one of those things where it's like, I don't want vehicles to go back here, but it's very obvious that, you know, there's like this like trail that's kind of leads back here, and then infantry get up to the top, and I don't know if you're going to be able to make it up this little hill. So I'm going to flatten this down a little bit. And this is kind of some of the stuff, too, that I would consider not really finished on Hossin. I think a lot of the outposts are honestly in better shape than I originally thought they were in, but some of the spaces between bases, like you know, you're looking at stuff like this where it's just a rock root placed down and then you don't have any of the like the pathing that goes normal alongside this. That's some of the stuff that I think is important to help get put together, too. Just to basically visually lead the player to go, okay, well, we've got a vantage point over here. Are there vehicles coming over here? I can flank vehicles from this point. That's kind of a way to look at that. Ginyu Force does rule. That's another thing too. We've got this like kind of rocky thing over here. So we're gonna have to get some more mud on the road. Same thing with this dirt road too. There's a lot of dirt here, and this road's supposed to be pretty muddy. Yeah, so you can see it kind of starts with the dirt over here, and then kind of gradually fades into that. How far does this mud go? And it goes right back in the mud, so I guess we'll keep this top because there's a little bit of height difference here. So we won't put too much mud on the road. I do want to get on the rock painting that's going to be over here. SPQX, sorry, butchered the name. What's the current use of the mesas? I saw somebody mention earlier that galaxies were up there, but I haven't quite seen that yet. Another thing that I'm covering up here, this not all that good looking seam. I take this rock and put it here. And squash it a little bit and sink it down, and it kind of melds into the scenery. Next, we're going to tear the grass off this because it's distracting from this little rocks that I'm going to paint into it. We'll have to take the plateaus being used for spawn capping on a case by case basis. If you want to slash bug those in game that people are using those specifically for spawn camping, we can try and figure out a solution to help alleviate that. Yeah, I mean, we might end up having to kind of like lop some of those down a little bit too. Some of the mountains on might be a little bit too high. Like in the case of this one, I don't know what we're able to do over here. Depends if you get like a vehicle up here, but it's pretty good luck spawn camping the spawner from there, but you can hit that teleporter room. But I already plan on putting trees around that area over there too, so Jadrick asked how my level design would change if spawns were destructible through SCUs on most bases. I haven't put a ton of thought. I haven't been involved in the SCU placement that they've currently done on live yet. I think we'd have to have a couple meetings and see how that works, because putting the SCUs on Indar was kind of an experiment to see how that would pan out again. We haven't explored that since launch. So the spawner from the plateau. Spawn room is over here. SPQ, if you sit up here, you can't see the spawn room from it. I don't think from any angle. The trees are just too big. And this one, you can kind of see it. So I'll check out putting some trees or planters with trees in them over here in front of the spawn room. Maybe one right over here. That doesn't hang over the thing too much. So yeah, this one I would say is kind of a pain to look at when it comes to that. But also we can do this. We've got this tree over here I placed. Oh no, that's sloppy. So we can do with this is just take this branch, assuming I'm in object tool. That ain't the right branch. Hide that branch, copy this branch, move this branch down, rotate it, and scale it down a little bit. It's a little bit harder to camp over there. Once again, distracted from the road. Alright, time to get out our painting tools. continuing with the vertex painting over here, pulling that over. I've got some green stuff on the road over here. Goes down to that, and this road flows into the other road. So this is going to fork over here. Got a little bit of work on the geo here before we do anything. Let's change it to Hossin. I think that might show some. No, that's not good at all. What do we got? Is that better? That's not better at showing contrast either. Turn shadows. Nope. Back to map render. Dexter, there is a ton of things that are taken into consideration when we are putting together a base. Performance, flow, what other bases are around it, what the theme of it's supposed to be. There's a lot of different things that kind of get taken into consideration when you're starting to put one together. It's difficult to, off the top of my head, it's difficult to kind of name them off. It's stuff that's just kind of become like, okay, I'm working on a base, and then you just kind of start with it. Like, even when it comes down to, like, placing a vehicle terminal, or a vehicle pad, rather, you have to make sure that it goes out 30 meters from it. So this one might not even fit that criteria. I haven't checked it, but we're going to check it now. This one looks like it's alright. Taking a right turn might be rough. I'm gonna push that back a little bit. How much space do we got? I got some space. Alright. Thank you for asking that question. So now I can make this adjustment that will do this base better. There we go. You should be able to take a right turn out of that. A little bit easier now. Yeah, performance is a big deal. It's not so much beforehand, but while you're doing it, I mean, you can't go too wild with objects and props and stuff like that. Especially in Hossin, the amount of like foliage and stuff that's around kind of limits us a little bit in what we're able to do in bases. They're a little bit less intensive than the Amherst ones we put together were. Yep, distracted from the road again. It's difficult to keep tasking on things. This is just generally how I work, too. Where I'll see something, work on something else, and come back to it eventually. There's a lot of small details that it's easy to get distracted with. So when I start painting rocks and stuff like that, I'll have to end up adjusting plants and stuff that are nearby. Like this. So make sure that the road's pretty uniform. Any of these like stripes that are going through it are just going to get worn out by tanks going over it, so we want to make sure that we reflect that with these paints going through. And the same with this side. This also needs the vertex painting on it fixed. Gonna eyedrop that and start painting it over this way. Swipe on this before, so I didn't see any of that paint there. There we go. Yeah, Amherst revamp was a lot of fun. I actually don't know what this computer specs are, Slayer Fang. I think it's pretty good, but there's not too many bad computers here. Grass there and exposing some rocks, so I gotta paint that back up with dirt. This is all gonna get rock painted on these little faces here. You can kind of see the lumps that I've kind of pulled out of that, so those are gonna be the rock faces we'll see out of that. That's gonna get painted with dirt up on top because it looks silly. I'll probably use mud in the cracks here to kind of really highlight the changes between these. So you don't see too much contrast if you paint just rock on this. And you just have the dirt bordering it. It doesn't look as good if you just start painting mud on mud between the cracks there. grass under here never stops. These two, when you're painting these kind of rock faces in here, we're going to take the vertex coloring on those and change those up a bit. Yeah, Spokes, but that's a good way of thinking about it. And for FPSs, especially when you're in a totally PvP game like ours, you want to make sure that the players are together, because if there's nothing, there's no one to fight. You can see sometimes off hours, you'll run into spots where you won't see any of the big fights anymore. It's good to keep the players together at that point. If you're looking at something like EverQuest, where it's like people get pretty defensive about encroaching on their dungeon spawns, if you're not in an instance. Too, when you're painting these rock faces in, we're going to start putting some regular rock props in there as well to kind of break it up, because it looks a little artificial when you just have that. Let's see here. Which boulder do I like for these? This one's good. Take O2. At least over there. Scale him up. Stick him in that. Kind of broken this up a little bit. That another thing too is that we're going to take the vertex painting. Let's see if we can find a bright rock. That's a good one to jack from right there. I'm going to paint these on here to highlight the rock faces in here. Even brighten it up a little bit more. So now we've got these brighter rocks, but we don't have the contrast that mud will give us. So we're going to get the brush out for this, and then kind of start putting that in between there. It's kind of the roads look pretty good when you start bordering with mud too, so maybe that's the way we can get around with getting mud up here. Some of those dark rock faces, and back to just painting mud between the cracks. I'm gonna use something a little bit more gentle for these. I see like the harsh patterns there. I don't know if that looks good or not. I don't think so. So I'm gonna just blur it out with just using a brush that's kind of just a softer. I think that looks better. wash away some of that rock face over here. I have been saving. My work should be alright. Fingers crossed. Not sure about warp gate invulnerability. I haven't heard anything internally about it, but that does not mean anything. If it's back on PTS, it might be a plan change soon. Yes, Senior Steve. Senior Steve asked if the editor that we're using allows multiple designers to work on the same content at once. Our maps kind of broken into little pieces called chunks that are that can be checked out in our version control software independent of each other, so multiple designers can work on the same content at once rather than having to check out the whole thing. Not having that would significantly slow us down, because we have anywhere from, you know, like 6-7 people sometimes working on the content at the same time, depending on how quick we need to get something out. Here to break up this flat face like that is going to just take some of these and place them down like that. Same thing with some foliage clumps. I really like ferns, so I'm going to place these over here. Scale them up a tiny bit, tilt them over. Have to figure out what to do with our buddies, the reeds over here. So we've got this flat look over here, so what I'm going to do is tap up the sides over this. Kind of make it look like it's built up a little bit on the sides. It might be a little too high. Exciting thing to watch, but so there we go. We've kind of got these little berms over here that look like the mud is kind of built up alongside of this wall. Kind of breaks up the monotony of a flat plane. So I'm going to start scratching the road into this dirt now. go over this slightly with mud. This isn't really showing up as well as I'd like it to. Through here just to kind of give it a little bit more contrast when the road goes through it. It's still got a lot of the dirt texture in there, as you can kind of tell by like the grayish tones rather than dark brown, but as opposed to like over here where it's pretty much all mud. Try to even that out so you can't see the circle brush that's in there. Alright, now back to the Yeah, now we have a lot more contrast with the road brush that's going through here. Make this a bit smaller to get better scratch marks. We're painting this road with the tank treads brush that we have. It's kind of getting these nice scratch marks into the terrain. It's a pretty tight pass right there. I guess it's 7 meters wide, that's not so bad. Through here. got enough mud in it. So, Moochaman, I'm using a mouse and keyboard for everything right now. I have a tablet at my desk in the other building, but I typically use mouse and keyboard for this. Painting some finer details isn't bad with the tablet sometimes, though. So here we got the space back here. I don't necessarily want vehicles to even think about going back there, so I'm gonna place a tree cluster over here. Assuming it works. There. No reason to go back there now. All right, so this road looks acceptable for now. There's some spots where, like right over here, where they frame it with mud a little bit more, but I think that looks good. So we've got our basic framework now. We've got the road leading into it. We don't have any cover. We didn't do up the trees yet. And we've got another 15 minutes before I'm out of here. So, I think we're going to doll up these trees. Start. See how much of these trees we can get done before the clock's over. So let's kind of check out just really quick what the scale of these other trees are. So we've got this one I just placed over here. And the tree branches are scaled to half size, less than half size, a little more. Yeah. So, and the tree itself is half size. Half size, 7%. Okay, so we're going to probably scale most of these tree branches down to about half size. Take this one. Pull this back here and then up. We're gonna start trying to make this thing look like a tree rather than this big stump sticking out of the ground. So kind of these nubs that are good spots for placing the initial branches out of. I'm gonna take branch 02 and I'm also shrink this one down. Shrunk to 55% of its normal size. So there we go. We've got a really bad looking tree right now. So we're going to start messing around with this. I'm going to take this, rotate it, move it over. Now it's already looking a little bit better. I'm going to take this other branch and move it over here, shrink it down really tiny, and have it branch off of another branch. starting to come together a little bit. This one might be a little bit pulled in like that. Now for a lower cover, I'm going to start taking these and shrinking them really small. I'm just kind of placing them alongside where it might make sense to have these. Devin do on these pre-props to make them look so good? I guess that looks alright. Sort of. That looks a lot better. This one's going to be a little bit, have these scaled up a little bit since they are considerably larger. Probably not that vertical though. This is silly. Branch 02, branch 02, and branch 01. So I'm going to take another branch 01. Lower that. Spin it around. Shrink. Lower and rotate. What is this branch doing? Up here, I needed to make some smaller ones that are going to just fill up the visual space up here. And that looks okay. We're almost done here with these trees. Fortunately, we're getting close to wrapping this thing up for today. So for this tree, I'm going to take this branch and kind of continue it up like it's the main one. Maybe not. I don't think that looks good. these little branches down here to kind of help with the very close to the ground air cover. And whatever, we'll put another one down here. Just a couple more up here. It's a little sparse. Too many twos on this tree. I think those look pretty cool. They're a little bit differently shaped than the other trees that we have. And over here we might as well get a couple other trees because we've spoken about these. I don't want these to be too big. I want them to be more something that's going to suck up tank rounds coming here rather than super thick air cover. Should I get two? Over here when I'm finished with that over there. All right, we got time for leaf piles. It's our last action on this base before we have to go. So I like these leaf piles. They're pretty good at breaking up the monotony of this pattern when you see these mining platforms. Having little piles of these kind of like stacked under these trees kind of breaks up the visual repetitiveness of it. They're good because you can take them and kind of like slide them under so they're kind of like piled up against it. You can take them, put them in the middle. You can dupe them. That shrink them a little bit so they're kind of oddly shaped. Leaves are slippery. They're probably going to cause the majority of deaths at this base, Senior Steve. Place more leaf piles into the base of these trees. Just clutter that kind of accumulates on the ground. Araxis, unfortunately, doesn't have many janitors. We haven't added that class into the game yet. Space OSHA will not have any of this, absolutely not. The metal plates have actually been placed around these, if we're going to go with that lore background. I should probably make the dirt, the mud around these a little bit bigger, because they do look like they're growing out of metal plates, huh? Yeah, that's a good idea. I don't want to make the mud too like high off the ground, because that kind of limits what I can put in terms of cover on these, but then again, I can just put the swamp pods that have the red thermal on them and everything like that. So, I think we're about out of time here. So, thank you for joining us today on PlanetSide 2's Work in Progress Hossin Edition. I will continue to post updates on this on my Twitter account. You can reach me at Xander Clauss, as it says in the bottom of the screen right now. H1Z1 currently has a stream going on at 5:30 at twitch.tv/H1Z1. So check those guys out if you want to check out our upcoming zombie survival game. And that's it. I'll be on screen again in about 3 weeks or so, and I believe Malorn will be working on the Rustwash Offal Pit next week. So tune in again next week, Tuesday at 3 p.m. Pacific, and check us out. Thanks for coming again.